I think it could be possible, but probably only with Postgres, I think. In Postgres, you can name it cursor, which you can store or keep it and get it back on the next call. And so you keep the same cursor for multiple calls. And let's say you have a first RPC call, you get the name of the cursor. And on each other call, you give the same name it cursor, and you reuse it until you make a commit. But yeah. I don't know if it's very useful, indeed, because what I would do if I need to have multiple calls in one transaction, why not just create an entry point for all the codes? I have just one RPC call for that, and it does everything inside one transaction.
The name it cursor, is it linked to a connection? Because you will have to use the same connection. That's a good question.
You can name it after the login user.
Yeah, but when you connect, you don't know which connection you get, because there's a pool of connection. Is the name it cursor linked to the connection?
It's not a big thing.
probably here.
Cedric, the resolution is I think maybe something like that. But I don't think it's really useful for us. We probably should try to fix it by having one call.
You talked about direct debits in the API of how was it called?
Stripe.
Yeah, of Stripe, and I would like to ask how direct debit is working in Triton, and if it is, how is it possible to work in Triton with direct debit? Is there now no such restriction like on Stripe?
It is allowed.
The restriction with Stripe is that you have first to make some business with them for other stuff before they activate you the direct debit option. To work on direct, I don't know. How you work with direct debit, mainly you go to the payment form, select line you want to receive, and say, I want to receive them. Of course, this is a low level workflow because you have to go to each lines and select the Stripe customer for Stripe and the source, so
the account you want to make the debit and so on. So it's probably not the correct workflow for business. Usually you do that for subscription kind of business. And so I think you will store the information that this invoice should be paid with direct debit automatically when it's post, because it comes from the subscription where you have all the information. And indeed, I could probably show you what we do for Jurassic Fruit, because it is what we do. Direct debit, but Stripe debit. Indeed, what we did, we overwrite the post method of the invoice. We look at the invoice posted. We check that the invoice at least if one line on the invoice comes from a sale, which is indeed we store the information on the sale here, but it could be on something else, another document in upper level. And we have the payment type, which is a SEPA debit. We know it's requested by the customer. And then we loop over all the lines to pay. We check that the lines to pay doesn't have, doesn't have already a payment, any payment. And we have to do that because at some point we could have an existing SEPA debit that was failed for whatever reason, and we don't want to retry to pay always the same, trying to make the same payment that is failing. So we do only once. We just create the payment with the right amounts and so on. And at the end of the methods, we process those payments, and so it will, the cron after that will loop over this payment that is in processing state and call Stripe to charge it, to create the charge. So I think it most of the time, I guess it will be custom made logic, because depend on really on the business stuff, or maybe as we have a subscription module now, we could maybe it's a feature to add this kind of configuration of payment, and the invoice created by the subscription could be automatically paid. Yeah, that could be a new feature.
And do you reuse the CAMT ability for direct debit? I've read you have CAMT, CAMT.
CAMT? Ah,
CAMT,
yeah, it's this is for SEPA.
Direct debit?
Yes, with SEPA you can make direct debit. Here, instead, we use Stripe to generate for us the SEPA message to send to the banks, and so it's the services that Stripe provide us. Of course, we have the modules, the module account payment SEPA, which allows Triton to generate SEPA message that you have to send to give to your bank to make the operation. And one of these messages is direct debit. It's a little bit more complex to implement, I think, because first you have to agree with your bank how to communicate. You have to request the services from the bank. You are responsible in this case to manage the mandate, because to make a direct debit, normally you should request from your customer to sign a mandate that gives you the right to take money from his account. And you have to store this mandate and be able to reproduce it. And also the SEPA, I would say that the banks tend to not be fully compliant with the norm of SEPA. So you often find that you have to tune the standard message for your specific bank because she doesn't support something specifically, or they want to have it in another way because the norm is very large. And Triton, we implement the minimal message to be able to try to be the more compliant possible, but it doesn't work for all banks, for what we have seen for now. An example is in France. We have to create a specific SEPA module because they decided to implement SEPA, but with some customization and some other rules, and so the standard message doesn't work. So we have the CEFON here. Which is it's a specific flavor that works only in France. And for what we've seen for now, what we've seen is that we have to often tune the message for the specific bank.
I think it would be useful to support a view where many-to-one can be presented as a form in the same way that one-to-many can be presented as a form. I'm curious why that's not supported. Is there an idea to support it, or are there issues there?
First, we can support the one-to-many to be displayed as a form and so on, because of the APIs of the field. The API of one-to-many, when you set here, you set a value, indeed, it's operations that you define. And so we can make one call when you click on save on the main form, and you have a one-to-many in the form view. When you click on save, it will generate only one request that contains the rights of what we have modified in the main records. And as value for the one-to-many, you will have this kind of operator, and probably a write with the values you have to write. So it's some way it's nested. It's a nested call of multiple writes. And that allows us to show the form view of the one-to-many, because we can make one call to save everything. We save all the changes. And unfortunately, the many-to-one, the setter, indeed, I think there is none. There is no specific methods, set methods on many-to-one. And so we expect to have the value of the many-to-one, which is just the ID. So it's a classical field for Triton, and so it is expecting to have just an integer or none. And so if you have the form view of the many-to-one, we will need to support operators like this to know what has changed in the form view of the many-to-one. And so, that's why it's not implemented, because it's complex for that. I don't know if
is it good to try to implement and some way change the internal of the many to one to be able to perform this kind of operation? That's
so I think it would be useful because it would allow you to create views where the user is able to just see a single screen and enter in all the information that's needed for a number of models. And that the fact that it's not available it really prevents that in a lot of cases and forces users to move from one screen to another. Do you think it would be of great difficulty to add to the many-to-one a sort of conditional way of how it will be set that it could be receiving from the a form view versus the standard view?
I guess by breaking backward compatibility, we can. I think it should not be too difficult to implement in the client because at some point we will just do like we do with the one-to-many. But instead of multiple IDs, we have only one ID. It's maybe. But
the problem I can see is that if you change.
The problem I can see is that if you change a value in the, for lack of a better word, main record and a value in the many-to-one record, you have to decide an order in which it will be saved. You might break the domain, and you might make stuff not validated.
We have the same. It's the same as for one-to-many. So the validation of the main records happens after the validation of the fields inside. So we will write first on the lower on the many to one,
okay,
and after that on the upper, and the domains should apply, like we do for the one to many. We localize the domain for the form view inside. So I think it will not be really an issue. But at some point, it could also be solved by creating a one-to-many, which is indeed just the many-to-one, but in a list view, in a list, as a list. And you just limit the one-to-many to one record. Maybe it's an option that we
maybe we can create a function field.
Yeah,
a function field that does that
automatically.
Automatically.
Yeah, we could have like we have the some decorator for to get the translated string of selection. We could have a similar. Feature that create automatically for you the one-to-many that you can use as for the many-to-one. Maybe it's the
and we
the
can
simpler.
Also customize the way the one-to-many looks so people don't even know it's a one-to-many. So I think it could be a
I think
idea
it
and you should make an issue.
I don't think we have to change. Because you need to have the same functionality as the one-to-many. You need to create records, you need to delete records. Maybe indeed it should probably also have the @remove feature. You need to be able to link the records or remove the record or unlink the record. And so it will be a one-to-many with the @remove feature. Okay. No. Another question?
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah. What do you think of the PyPy interpreter? And do you think it would be useful for Triton to support it?
Yes, we I think we, at some point, we are a kind of, the kind of software that PyPy would be useful for. Because at some point, we are a long-running server, and PyPy is do the kind of optimization that we need for long-running server. And at some point, we support it, because normally you see here, which normally you should be able to run it, but yeah, we have the test. It's in the test, the tox definition, but we don't run it on your our continuous integration on drone, and we don't do that because we have an issue with the library PsychoPG 2CFFI. I think the issue. I think the library needs a new version to be published, mm-hmm. and they don't do it. PsychoPG 2CFFI. Yeah. Oh, maybe they've done the release. Oh, yeah. Yeah. So we should probably give a try and make the drone build it to ensure.
When we tried to play around with PyPy and Triton, we also had problems with Realatorio, I think, or maybe Genshi.
Ah, yeah.
Yeah. If I That's remember possible. Correctly. Yeah. maybe the calls to Unicorn or something like that. Not maybe Realatorio per se, maybe it was with Unicorn or.
We don't activate PyPy test on Relatorio, so. This should be the first things to do, and it's possible that we have problem with Genshi because Genshi uses a little bit internals of Python, and indeed we should remove Genshi for Kajiki. It's supposed to be a replacement, which is more maintained than Genshi. It's supposed to be compatible, so we can reuse, at least the template will work by default, but for what does what Relatorio does with Genshi, we will probably need to rewrite a lot of stuff for Relatorio. So. Probably for the release 1.0 of Relatorio, or if we don't manage for the release 2.0. But yeah.
Which next version will still support Python 2.7?
Python 2.7, it will be the last release before the end of the support of Python 2.7, normally, according to the rules. So, I don't know, when is there
End of support.
Ah, but normally it's the official. So it's in 3 years.
4.8.
4.8.
I think.
No, 4.8. It's the next one. Yeah, but we'll.
Can you imagine to support a version of Triton on 2.7 while 2.7 in end of support? No. So it means that if the end of life of the 4.8. I'm wrong.
No, but indeed. The policy that we define for Triton is that we support dependencies that are still supported. But for Python, I guess probably we should say that in 20, we should, the date of the end of the support of Python 2, we should have no release that we still support that are still in Python 2. So this means as we support a release for 3 years, two and a half, yes. So the next, the last one will be the next release, will be the last one with support for Python 2.
And it means that Triton 5 will be Python 3 only.
Yeah.
Yes.
Good. Five is a good number.
That's a good
number. Seven or so.
We already have
Okay, up. Like that, we remember. Yeah. And I think we will, the GTK client now run only on GTK 3. So we can start to plan to migrate the GTK client to Python 3. And I think we will migrate. Probably. So we will make now a release with Python 2 GTK 3, and the next one Python 3 only with GTK 3. Yeah. So makes sense. Nothing. I can. I don't know if there is another question. Or can show a workflow of something. I don't know what. What?
The email modules.
Ah yes. Is it installed? So things one or two release. We have a new modules, notification emails, which allow to define to send notification emails to when something happens to a record. And this goes in this is define here notification email. So I will create, let's say I want to send the a quotation to the party when I do a quotation for on the sale. So I need to create a notification email. I can fill a form if I want to say I sell it from saleexample.com. It's just the form in the email, but if you want to customize, otherwise it will use the default form address for in the configuration of Triton. And if it's empty, generate one based on the username of the system and stuff like that. I need the content. So what will I send to the party? So what I send is a report. I have to define a report, and for that I will create one. The extension should be you can send only HTML or plain text in an email. The core of the email should be something like that. If I write an HTML email, Triton will convert it into make a second version of the email in plain text for people who don't like to read HTML email. But yeah, to make it simple, I will write a plain text template. I will name it quotation email. It's run on the model on the sale. I have to give him a name, but I will say quotation email. Okay, and I will just save it like that for now, and I will write the email templates later. I have to decide to who I will send the email. So here the form knows that as I create a template for the sale, it shows me the field of the sale that I can use. So Triton is able to send an email to a user or to a party. It knows to find the email address of those two types of models. So here I will send to the party of the sale, the customer. I could define people who will be in copy or hidden recipients and so on. That's something. I can add an attachment to this email if I want. And the attachment are any report on the models for which the email is created. So here it's the sale, so I can attach any reports that are a report of the sale. And of course, I find my email, so I could attach my email in the email, but that's not very useful. But I can attach the sale order report. And finally, here I have to define the triggers. So when does this email should be sent? And we use the trigger that already exists in Triton to make other actions. And here we reuse the triggers. So I will create a trigger. I have to give him a name, apparently. Quotation. It's on the sale. It should be evaluated, let's say, when I create a sale or when I write on a sale. I could create directly a quotation, so like that it will be sent. And I have to give a condition when to send this email. So the trigger will be run when the condition before the modification, so before the write, was false, evaluate to false, and after the write, it should be evaluated to true. So here, what I will say is that the self or this?
Self.
Okay. Self is the sale order. It's the record for which we are evaluated the trigger. And so it's a Python expression. And I have to. Okay, attribute error. So up. I will check the state of the sale, and if it equals to quotation, I send the email. I can define here, put a limit if I want, but that's not useful here. I can say I send only once. If I quote it multiple times, I don't send each time an email or not. But let's say I will put zero, it's better. And these are automatically filled because I create a trigger for the notification email. This is the method, the configuration you have to do to use for this kind of trigger. And so they are fill it. And indeed, I cannot change it normally. Oh, I can, but it's not a trigger. Probably it should be read-only. I don't know. We cannot make it read-only because it's a domain. I don't know. We could check later. I will save. Now, if you remember, I didn't put any content on my email template, so I will write one. We use Relatorio to generate that, so it's still Genshi syntax. So I will say email txt. I forget to say something here. I work with it's a single report. It's a new feature from 4.6. It means until now every report should be written to work with a list of records and generate the document for a list of records. And now you can say the report works only with one record, and so it will be called with only one record in it. This is useful for emails because we know it will always be called with one record to send the email, and the syntax for Genshi will be easier. So in this case, we have the object record. So I could say, here is the quotation for an. No, that's Jinja syntax. I will check. Yep. Relatorio. $. So it's for record name, record number. Will I have a yes? Attachment. Okay, so I will use this S template. So I select email text, save it, hop, et voilà. So I will quote this, but first I will show you. It's a small script. I write fake SMTP. So it's a fake
email server that will receive the email that Triton will send. And it will display it here.
I'm interested in this script.
Okay. Up. Same thing. It's just one line of code. This is the line of code. Okay. And now I will just check here that the party for which I will make a quotation is an email address. So I have to add to the contact mechanism an email. Okay, so now we have an email address. And I will quote. Connection refused. Ah, okay. My server is not configured to use my fake email server. So here I will have to configure the email. Should be something like that. Quote. Done, and I didn't receive an email. okay, no, that's not. ah, wait. TP, c'est bon. Is the email address was correctly saved? Yes. Ah, yes. Data manager, ok. String payload expected a byte array. String payload.
You must decode message as string
in Python 3. Yeah, no, but it's Python 2. It looks like the attachment is sent as a text. In here? No.
Là, c'est string et il s'attend. Non, ça, c'est un byte array, il s'attend
un string. So. Maybe I don't have the last version. Okay. First. I will try first something. I will remove the attachment and we will see if it's the problem. No attachment. Save. I send it. Yeah. I received the email, the quotation, but I have no attachment. So probably there is something wrong with the notification when I put the attachment. I guess if
you just if you have few time, I could. Draft code and in the I think so I have the attachment here. What happens, I think, is that here we guess the main type of the report, and it says it's an open document text. And I guess here the when I set the payload, he think it's a text, a plain text, and so he put it the raw the data like that instead of converting it into a payload data. And so that's the problem, but we can fix it. It will be fixed tomorrow. I will create an issue. So how do you create an issue? You go to bugtriton.org, create an issue. Bug, crash. Progress. Any question on this? Is it clear? Everybody can redo that? and the from, I guess we will see. It's the from of the email. And as you can see, the problem here, the two-phase commit data manager for sending email is not completely proved. It means in such case, the exception happens too late, so we cannot roll back the transaction and prevent validating or quoting the sale. That's because we created a simplified data manager for sending email. It's not fully transactional. So when you have bugs, it could happen. But the email is not sent. Another question? I don't know. Time.